ऑलराइट गाइज, वेलकम टू आवर चैनल कोड विद सन्नी। एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस द इजी प्रॉब्लम विच इज़ द फोर्थ प्रॉब्लम ऑफ डेली लीट कोड चैलेंज ऑफ जनवरी 2022। इट्स इंडेक्स इज 1009। ओके, एंड द प्रॉब्लम नेम इज कॉम्प्लीमेंट ऑफ बेस 10 इंटीजर। एज द नेम सजेस्ट, यू नीड टू फाइंड आउट द कॉम्प्लीमेंट। आई थिंक या सो द कॉम्प्लीमेंट ऑफ एन इंटीजर इज द इंटीजर यू गेट वेन यू फ्लिप ऑल द जीरोज टू वंस एंड ऑल द वंस to zeros in its binary representation. Okay, and like if you first, like you have been given some integer, you need to first convert that integer to some binary representation, and then whatever the, like at the corresponding bit position you are facing the one, then you need to revert that one to zero and vice versa, and then you are going to find out the number corresponding to that binary representation that will be called as the complement of the given number n. Okay, so if you're not understanding this right now, no need to worry about it. I'm going to explain with the help of examples. So here one thing that is being like quite interesting is like n is starting from 0. Okay, so you need to mention the, like you need to handle the base case also. I will explain it out how it is going to be done. Okay, so let's understand this with the help of examples. Okay. So the background is of grid type, so let me change. Yeah, now it's good. So like we have been given some integer n, right? So let's say n is like 5. Okay, so what is the binary representation of 5? It is like 101. Okay, so the complement of 5 is like reverting all the ones at their respective position to 0 and vice versa. So we are facing the 1 over here, so I will revert this 1 to 0. You are facing this 0 over here, I will revert this 1, and from 1 to 0. So this is our new binary representation, which is called the complement of number n. Okay, so we have to find out the decimal value of this binary representation, which is coming out to be 2. Okay, so this will be your answer. So one of the way to solve this problem is like first you are going to find out the total number of bit positions. So let me write down total number of bit positions of n. So if you have been given n, how will you find the total number of bit positions of n? You will just do a simple logarithmic log 2 to the like log n to the base 2. Okay, so you will find that for 5, this value will come out to be exactly 2. So you can see there are total 3 bit positions starting from 0, 0, 1, 2. Okay, so if you take n as 8 and if you will do log 2 of 8, then you will get as 3. So it means that there are 3 plus 1, 4 bit positions starting from 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, like that. And if you write down the binary representation of 8, it will be like 0, 0, 0, 1. It's like 2 raised to the power 0 position will be here, 2 raised to the power 1, 2 raised to the power 2, and 2 raised to the power 3. Finally, you can see the set bit equal to 1 has 2 raised to the power 3. That's why the value is 8. Okay, so what you are going to do is you are going to find out the total number of bit positions and iterate through all bit positions and check it out. If there is a set bit equal to 1, then you will revert that to 0, and if it is 0, you will revert back to 1. Okay, so that approach will take you to the complexity of log 2 to the base n, because we are finding out the total number of set bit positions. Okay. So there are another approach also, and the next approach would be like this one. So let me say n is like 5. So you will write down the binary representation 101, and if you will find out the complement, you will see it will come out to be 010. Okay. So you can do this directly also. How you are going to do this? Note that what actually we are doing is like we are just subtracting out this minus this. Actually the value corresponding to this, like filling all the ones at all the bit positions minus the actual number, it will give you this value 010. Note that I'm talking about the decimal value. This here I've written the binary representation. If you find out the decimal value and this decimal value, if you will subtract it out, then you are going to get this one. Why this is happening? Because you can see that actually if the set bits is already set to 1 and finally in our actual number n it is set to 1, if you will subtract it out, the set bit position equal to 1, the value corresponding to that will be lost. Then you are going to get 0 at this position. Now consider this position, the set bit is set to 1 and the here set bit is set to 0. It means that the value is not containing here and the value is containing over here. Then if you will subtract the value, then the value must remain as it is, because here the position is like 2 power 1. So it will be 2 and here the position is 0. It means that you are not going to get any value. So the value is 0 over here. If you will subtract it, you can see you are getting 2 as it is. So it means that whenever the some position where the bit is set and the other position in the other number the bit is not set, you will subtract it, the bit will remain as it is. Okay, so the other method is like you will find out the L, which is like log 2 of n. Okay, and what you do is like you will fill all the bit positions to 1. So you are going to write down 2 raised to the power L plus 1 minus the actual number n. This will be your answer. How you can say that this is correct? No, 2 raised to the power L plus 1 minus 1. Okay, so let me write down clearly. So it should be like 2 raised to the power L plus 1 minus 1 minus n. Okay, so this will be our answer. How this is happening? You can see if I am writing 5 over here and its binary representation is 101 and I need to fulfill like this pattern. So this value is 7. This value is 7, right? So this value is actually can be written as 2 power 3 minus 1. Okay, and now you can see 3 is the value which is like L plus 1. So here you can see for 5, L is like log 2 of n, which is coming out to be 2. Okay, so if you will do L plus 1, it will become 3 and you can write this as 2 power 3 minus 1. Okay, so similarly, the same approach can be applied to any of the numbers. Okay, so let's head over to the code to find out how we are going to implement this. I will write down 2 methods to solve this problem. Okay, so let me just, yeah, this is no need. I hope the screen is visible. Okay, so first I will write down int n as log logarithmic 2 to the base, like n to the base 2, and my answer would be 0. And I will iterate for every number like i0 to I less than L or less than equal to L. I don't know. So if it is 5, so it will be like 2. Okay, I think it should be less than equal to L. Okay, and I will go for every number. And if the bit is set 1 less than I and the number n, then I will say do nothing. Otherwise, you are going to add the answer, because here it becomes the like the value, like the bit is set to 0. Bit is 0 here. So we need to add the number, otherwise skip it, because we need to find the complement of the number. And finally, we are going to return the answer. But here you can see you are going to get a runtime error, because log 2 of n is not defined for n equal to 0. And in our actual problem statement, you can see n is varying from greater than or equal to 0. So you need to write down a base case. If not equal to n, means that n is 0, you need to return like 0's complement would be 1. I think this should work fine. Let me submit. Okay. There is some compilation error. What is this int n? Okay, so this should be L. So, yeah. Okay. Yes, this works fine. You can see that runtime is 0 ms and 100% faster than submissions. Okay, so I'm working for another solution. So let me just write down another method to solve this one. So it should be like if the base case, if not equal to n, return 1. And let me find out the max value, which should be like filling all the ones. It should be like 1 less than L plus 1 minus 1. This is the max value. And you are wondering that what is L over here. So L is like log 2 of to the log n to the base 2, and my current value is n, so we need to return only max value minus the current value. I think this should work fine. Submit it. Yeah, this is working fine. So if you have any doubts regarding anything, regarding time complexity or anything, so you can mention in the comment section of the video. And thank you for watching this video.